Building a website doesn't need to be hard anymore. There are some great AI block-based builders that can allow you to build a site really quickly. And I'm going to go through two of them that I've actually used personally and compare this to why this is such a better experience for building a website than something like WordPress. Now, granted, most sites on the internet are built with WordPress, but the problem with WordPress, great framework, but there's so much built on top of it. You need so many plugins, and plugins can conflict and cause problems with other plugins. And it's just a mess. And it's just not built for building block-based websites either. And that's a big deal, because if you look at the rise of the popularity of website builders, if you look at things like Wix and Squarespace, although they're a little bit on the expensive side, they make it easy for someone to build a website with blocks. And that's what we're going to be talking about here. But this way, you're going to have more control. And by the way, either of these options, you don't even need a domain name to get started. So it's really easy to take that vision out of your head and put onto paper. So I'm going to show you two of them and my experiences with building them. So first, let's look at Invisible Creator. So this is a product that I created that teaches a course on how to make YouTube videos without showing your face. So this is, I didn't do a logo for it. So it's just got the title here, and I did an avatar. They make it really easy to make a gravatar to it. And here's a navigation bar, and these are all different blocks, right? So this is a block. And the great thing about this is you can have this block on multiple pages. So you update it on one page and it updates on everything automatically. It's really built for simple, not exact specifications. And I'll explain what I mean by that in a little bit, but this, I made this graphic and then a little headline, watch the video. And this just goes to an anchor. So an anchor is a different block or different section on the page. And it's really easy to link to anchors. So I actually spent a lot more time on this site. This is just a big image, and you can see I put some different details there, put up some just screenshots that I found of people building. So these are all different blocks, right? And the great thing is, if you want to change all these colors at once, you can just go from blue to purple and it can update all the pages at once. So this is an embed of a tweet, right? So you can embed whatever you want, whether it's YouTube videos. Here's another embed on a tweet. You can change these icons. And of course, I made this graphic. My wife made it actually, but I don't want to take too much credit for it. But you can see it's just blocks. And then here's your teacher section. And so you just throw in these different blocks and it pulls the whole site together. Okay. So this is a bit of a longer site. This is a GIF. So you can embed GIFs. You can have these FAQs, testimonials, and then you have the bar at the bottom, you know, the footer bar. And you can make lots of different pages with this. I've actually made a few different pages, and maybe I'll show you some of those as well in this video. So this is another site that I made. And again, this is actually not well designed, but I just want to throw up something quickly, just a pop-up. And so that's actually made through a third-party service. So what these sites do is they allow you to put stuff in the code on a specific page or on all the pages, which is great if you're doing tracking. So I made this graphic. You'll see the same sort of thing, and this goes to an anchor. So if I click it, it goes right to like the buy button. But essentially a block. This is like a headline block. And then I actually put against the right of play, against what you're supposed to do, I put links here on my sales page, big image here. And then you have these little call outs. And I like how this is almost a little bit faded. You can see that it's darker on this side, the text, and another call out heading. What you don't get with these block-based builders is a lot of the customization that you can do with WordPress to make these closer together. But the truth of the matter is people are watching on different types of devices. So these are all responsive. If someone's watching this on a mobile, they're going to be closer together anyhow. So if you design it for your specific viewing experience, it's not really going to do anything. And so I try to focus on the action of getting it done and getting something that's good out there as soon as possible. So we're going to go through the different templates that they have. This is just an image. So details in an image. And then again, here's what's in the course. Now, one thing that I do want to point out with Lindo is they basically had this block with the image and then three bullet points. And I couldn't add more bullet points, so I put it in like this. And I talked to the developer. They're actually really responsive. Both teams are. They have great support. They get back to you very quickly. And he's actually going to be developing that. And then here's like a testimonial block. And like this just happens automatically, where it comes in. It's already designed like that. You can fiddle around with that kind of stuff if you want, but this is how the FAQs are. And there you go. So what I want to do is I want to show you the inside of these different platforms, just how it works. So Lindo, this was the site we just saw here. You can see it's really made for blocks, but I want to show you the inside. And this is exactly made on Lindo. You can see like the blocks. So you can have these testimonial walls and all kinds of stuff. I actually had this block on my site. I use it a little bit different. I'll show you that. The button looks familiar. You can change that kind of stuff. But again, I'd say, do you really want to do that? Or do you want to focus on getting your message out there? Because trust me, there's some really ugly sales pages out there. Now, this is a little bit different unicorn platform. And I'll go through the pricing of what that is as well. This is a product of the day and product of the week on Product Hunt, and create your website for your project fast. I'm going to show you the website builder because this is really awesome. And this just shows you what you do. You just pick a template and it will do it for you. As you can see, this looks very similar. This is the template that I used. And again, there's not a ton of options if you want to really customize and move things around. And if you're doing that, then yes, you do need a web developer. But you do need to work with Figma or something to wireframe things out. But this is a really great way to build a website. So I want to show you how to do it. And first, let's go into Lindo. Okay, so I'm going to sign in. And this is my site. So I'm actually going to show you what it looks like on the inside here. And it actually created all these pages with AI. I'm going to actually create a page and show you how that works just as a demo. But since I showed you the home page, and it created all those pages for me like in like seconds, which is great because it takes the wind out of your sails when you're building something and you're making a privacy policy. So here it is, back to the editor. And each of these options, you can change the layout. So for the blocks, they have variation 1 looks like this, variation 2 looks like this. So they look pretty similar. It also says request variation. One of the problems with Lindo is you can use your own assets. You can use stock photos. You can search for them. So if I wanted to find something related to email, I could just do a search and it pulls up everything from Unsplash and I can just put that in there. Let's say I wanted to use that instead. It will just pop that in there. One thing that it can't really do is reposition the images. And I talked to the developer about that. They're actually working on that and that should be available for next week. So you can link to any of your assets. You can link to a URL. You can also link, so this one links out. So again, not necessarily what you might want to do. And here is the different blocks. So you can just add any block in you want. And let's take a look at some of these blocks here because I think this is pretty interesting. This one, Lindo AI, has more blocks. And you can see announcement with icon, alerts. So if I put this in, you can actually change what you want. So if you want it to be, the red alert, if you want it to be the green alert, then it can change that. Okay. And I'll just show you some of the different blocks here. So simple text, this actually has better text blocks. If you just want to just put some blocks in, I do find this a little bit annoying on Lindo. It will pop up with this feedback all the time. That's good. So you can put in white space here, a simple heading and text. There's more options for text, blog card. You can see how those look. Basic banner, so you can see those. A call to action box, the footer. I use this on my site. I showed that. Here's the Product Hunt banner, blog banner. So I'll go down to the Product Hunt banner. So I actually had this on my site, and then I hit it. So I see how it's grayed out. This is actually the block, but I went inside and I went to hide. So I can click show and I can show it or I can hide it. So it's actually there on the page, but if someone's going to the page, it's not going to show. So what else do we got? this looks really nice. If you have an app, or even if you don't have an app, you can change the button text. Like, it just, you just plug this in if you have an app, and boom, you can just customize this text. Download now and save money, right? Whatever the thing is. And then you can actually link this to a URL, to a different app, or to an anchor, which is a different place on the page. So it's really customizable. Now, this is actually a live page, so I'm not going to be saving these changes, but it's easy as clicking save and then publish, and then boom, like in seconds, you're live. And this site, I didn't even get a domain name for, so it's published as deliverability.lindoai.com, and it's like live. So you can just send the link out to people, no domain name, you know, no email setup, none of that stuff. You can embed Calendly, which is awesome. You can embed Airtable forms. You can embed Apple Music things, Eventbrite. These are all built in. LinkedIn profiles, Instagram posts. Hey, that's messy. Google Maps. So it's really easy to just throw any of this stuff in. Loom video. So you can, a lot of SaaS companies will just do a Loom video and that's their sales process. You can throw it in and customize how it looks. You can throw in your testimonials from Senja if you use that, or Praise Hive, or Product Hunt. So this Product Hunt wall that Product Hunt popularized, you can put like all these testimonials there. Spotify, a whole bunch of things. Of course, YouTube. And look, you can do this, embed videos and playlists, lots of different options for that. FAQs, again, really nice. A couple different options there. A couple different options here with this one. Feature with stats. These are just really nice. So I'm not going to go through all of them, but you can see with the two images. Now, this is one where it's really going to help when you can actually customize the image and like reposition, like you can, let's say, on a Notion frame. But again, these bullets or these icons at the top can be customized. Feature list with the banner, feature SAS, and then footers. It just keeps going on and on. They've got a ton of stuff. Hero tile dark, background image with an image in the background. It just keeps going on and on. I'm not even showing all of these. And you can see like pricing blocks. Like once you pick one of these, then you get the different options. This one's got some nice stylings in the background just to make it cool looking. Here's a standard four option pricing. Team matrix, 404. It's just really well designed. You can see how if you did this, you couldn't go wrong. Your site would look pretty good. Also, there are design settings where you can set some of these settings. You can set the font, custom font, all that kind of stuff. And you can put in your custom code here for the header and the footer and on the analytics page. So you can do all of that. Now, let's go and create a new website, and then we'll go back into Unicorn platform and look at that option as well. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just click create a new website and I'm going to call this best chips or us. Okay. And what I'm going to do is this is going to make a whole website for me, which is pretty cool. What I like about this is there's some templates. So they have a starter template, an online business, and it says what they're best for. I like that this has a digital product option, and this is different from the Unicorn platform that has a lot of templates as well, but not so much for digital products. So let's say that we are doing, let's just do this online business, okay? And let's just say our thing is Chips or Us, and let's say we make the best chocolate chip cookies you have ever had. Soft, juicy cookies and the best and the creamiest milk. Okay. So I'm not giving it a lot to go on here, and I can't spell chocolate apparently. So it's going to be basically generating the whole website, right? One other thing I will mention about Lindo is a lot of their tours are silent. So they do have good tours and they show how to do things, but it is silent. Keep that in mind. There are some things that can improve. Let's see what it creates here for us. So again, the AI generation, this is not what you'd want to hang your hat on as like a site, but when you think of building a site, for me at least, I think, oh my gosh, you know, there's so many things to think about. These different components of layout, these different sites, these different pages, like the privacy policy, building a blog, all that kind of stuff. And that makes it very difficult when you want to create something. So as you can see, it's creating something. It's done. It's made all of these pages for me, which is crazy. So let's look at it. So this is Chips or Us. You could just put in your logo here. Looks very similar. And indulge in chocolate chip cookie bliss. So it's got some images here. These images would obviously need to be changed, but let's put some different things in. So you can see this, if this were your product and you actually had a cookie business, you could see, okay, I can have a picture here and indulge in cookie heaven. This is because we selected the SaaS template, right? So it's putting in some of these different numbers that wouldn't be necessarily applicable. The same kind of thing. You could, obviously that's why it has the integrations, but, and the pricing, but like here, it's already done the FAQs, right? Why they're the best. And do you offer like wholesale and bulk orders? So obviously things would need to change. You'd want to do this more with something that you're actually like building, and then find something that you want to do. But that's not all. Okay, that actually created that. It also created a services page here. And again, this is more in the SaaS mode. So it's like, let's talk and things like that. It created an articles page. It created a privacy policy. So this is all like done for you. You can update it obviously with the date. And it's done a couple keyword blog posts here as well. So as you can see here, unleashing the power of chocolate chip cookies. And it's written a very long blog post that has a lot of chocolate chip cookies in it. And this is great for, and see how long this is? That's a long article. And that's great because for a lot of SaaSes, that's how you're going to rely on maybe bringing in traffic. You're going to write a very good detailed article about a subject that your product helps about. And then you can customize it. So I like that it gives you that length, something to shoot for, because Google obviously loves long videos about that. Okay. This has all been done for me in a few minutes. It's got a contact page, and then any of these pages I can go in and I can edit. If I wanted to edit it, I would just go in and edit using this button. And then all that editing I can do, this is preview mode. It shows it defaults to preview mode. And then you can do all your changing and add your blocks and all that stuff and customize it. But you've got something to go with, something to start with. And that's what I think is really important. Okay, so now let's jump into Unicorn Platform.